Hello everyone, welcome to part 198 of Ecom series. In Laravel 6, we will continue working on PayU money payment gateway for our Ecom website. And in last video, we have seen one issue is coming in our transactional API that we are implementing. Okay, so we have implemented that single order we can check, but whenever we are doing all the orders together in loop, then we are getting some issue. So that can be resolved simply. Just key and salt must be in for each loop, and that can resolve the issue. Just you need to bring it down like this here, and that can resolve the issue every time this key and salt required for every order. So that's where the issue is coming. So only thing, you need to bring key and salt in for each loop itself, not outside but inside. Okay, so this is the only thing that you need to do, and I have saved this one, and now I am going to try. See, here we are getting the issue. This issue we are getting whenever we are checking last five orders. We have done for last five order in descending order, means latest five orders we are picking, and we are checking latest five orders whether their status vary with PayU Money or not. If their status vary, then we are going to update the status. Here you can check out that last five orders. Here you can check out that these are the last five orders, like this one. These are the last five orders. Okay, so one of the order like this one, its status we have seen, its status is payment captured, and here it is new. You can check here that we have seen this particular status. We have seen the status of this order 2450020 status is success captured. It means it is payment captured, so its status must be there, will be payment captured. Okay, must be payment captured. So here I am going to see the ID here, and this is the ID. Okay, so this is the ID here. The status is new, but the status must be payment captured. So whenever we will run this API, its status will automatically get updated to payment captured. Okay, so we are going to test now that the API will run fine or not. Okay, I'm going to run this one manually. I'm running this one, but later on we are going to do with cron job. Okay, so I am going to run this one once again, and we'll see. Okay, so I'm going to refresh this one, and we'll see. Here I have refreshed, and this time cron job runs successfully. This time the API runs successfully, and we can check now the status must be updated to payment captured. This status must be updated to payment captured. Okay, I'm going to refresh now. Okay, so after refreshing, it is reversing, so no issue. Now see, the status of this order is payment captured. Now the status has been updated from new to payment captured. Okay, so it means our API is working fine. Now you can test with other orders as well. What you can do, you can make the status as payment failed for some of the orders. The status will update to payment captured, and you can make payment captured to payment failed and payment failed to payment captured. Here means vice versa, because if in case the status at our end is payment captured by mistake, but there is the payment status is payment failed, then also we need to update. Okay, so in both cases we need to update the status. So what we can do, we can update the status from admin panel. I will update like payment failed to payment captured. Okay, this status I'm going to make it payment captured, and this one I'm going to make like payment failed. Okay, like this one I'm going to make it like payment failed. Okay, and here also I'm going to make it like payment failed. So few order status we have reversed, few order status we have make it means incorrect status we have added here, and now we are going to check that all these status must be correct. Okay, I'm going to refresh, and we'll see here. So the status of 20 is payment failed, though it is payment captured. This status must be, I think, payment failed, and it is payment captured, and this one also must be payment captured, but it is payment failed. So three order status must be updated with API this time. I'm going to run the API once again. Okay, I am going to run, and we'll see now. I'm going to refresh now, and we'll see. And once again I will do like this, and now you can see once again the status of 20 is here. It is payment failed. Okay, we need to check what the condition is its status must be payment captured. So here we need to update this one with payment failed. Okay, not payment failed. Here we need to update with payment failed. Okay, if the status payment failed and new, then payment captured. If the status of payment captured, and now it will work fine. I'm going to refresh once again. I'm going to run the API once again here. So now we can refresh and we can see the status here is now payment captured. That is fine. And here we have updated this status to payment captured earlier, and now it is payment failed. That is fine. And this one also we have updated to payment failed, and now it is coming as payment captured. So the status of the orders are updating correctly with the API. Okay, so now see, this is the manual process. So up till now we have done we have run the API manually, but now we need not to do like this. We will make cron job for our API so that it will run automatically after every half an hour. For that there is one website available, so we are going to use that website and we'll add the cron job there. But first of all we need to make this online. Okay, only then we can set that will not run our API offline. So I'm going to make these changes online first. Okay, so let's make these few changes online. I'm going to run FTP. We have set in last few videos, so you have seen that FTP we have set. So I'm going to run FileZilla. Okay, so I'm going to upload some of the changes that we have done so that we can run the API online as well. Okay, so I'm going to run here our website site manager, and our website name is this one, stackdevelopers.xyz. Okay, so I'm going to run this website. So here I'm going to check here our website. I'm going to update. So here also I'm going to open the same folder, and our folder name is sample 6, this one. Okay, so now here I'm going to check app resources. This is the same folder, fine it is. So I'm going to update resources. I can do like this one. So I can upload all the views here. I don't know which files we have updated in last few videos, so we can update all the files together. Okay, and we will also update the controller and model files as well, and route as well. Okay, after that we can check online. So I will open that website as well, stackdevelopers.xyz. okay, this is the website that we have created online in the last few videos. And now also we are going to open its admin panel. Admin 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, so I'm going to open its orders, but we need to place some orders. I'm going to log in here, meet2000@yopl.com. 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, so and here I am going to add some product also. See, this one is done. Now I am going to update model and controller file as well. So I will see that which files we need to update. Product model we can update. I don't remember that which file exactly we need to update, but we can update product model. Okay, so mainly we will update that controller files. Okay, so last modified file, see this one, pay you money controller is the new one. Products controller also we are going to update. Okay, so admin controller also, sorry,
Yeah, we can update updates controller. So admin and user controller also we have updated. In last few videos we have updated these as well. Okay, so these files we can update here. And now so I'm going to update the route as well. Then we will see route also. We are going to update route web.php file. I'm going to update. And one more thing I'm going to check, that the files, the new files that we have added, IndiePay package we have added. So vendor folder we need to update. So this is the most important thing we need to do, because vendor folder we have not updated. See the package here, we need to check the package here. So it might not work, because see the IndiePay package is not there. You can check it out. Okay, so now we need to update many more files. We need to update because the package of this this one IndiePay package is not there at all. So I'm afraid that it will not work. So I'm going to update this composer.json file as well. Okay, so I can update this file as well. Let's see. I'm not sure that it will work fine or not, but we have no other option. And also we can update vendor folder. Okay, so I'm going to click on skip. Okay, so let's see. I'm not sure that it will work. Otherwise what we need to do, we need to clear the files of our folder and need to upload them again. If it will not work, then that is the only way that we can do. We need to clear the earlier files and can only update. So it will take some time. We need to wait for some time and we'll be back. Okay, so the website, I'm going to open one website, one free website for cron jobs. Okay, where we can set the cron job, new cron job. Okay, so that is I think cronjobs.org. see, yeah, this is the website. Okay, I think this is the website. I'm going to open this website. Yeah, this is the website. Here we want to add the cron job that will run automatically after every half an hour. But first we need to manually run the API online. Only then we will make it dynamic. We'll make its cron job. Okay, so it is taking some time. Wait for a few minutes, then we will see again. Okay, now so few files are left now, and in vendors folder we need to update vendor folder because we have updated package online. we have updated package earlier on. We have updated package offline, that NDP package we have done for PayU Money. Now we are updating files for update that packet online as well, and we are skipping the files that are we are not overwriting the file so far. We are just installing the package. After that we need might need to overwrite few files as well. Okay, so I am searching that what files we need to overwrite in Stack Overflow. So I have got one answer that add the packet to the vendor folder that we are doing with FileZilla. Okay, so add a reference. This file we are going to replace in Composer folder, and this is another file that we will replace in Composer folder as well. Then we are going to check. Okay, so then it might work. We will check. Only few files are left now, then we will see whether it will work fine or not. Okay, I am telling you about the website that here, so we can sign into this website. We can here you can become the new member of the website. Okay, and here is the sign up. You can be new member of the website. Like I can be told like this: Amit Gupta, Amit PHP programmer, gmail.com. Okay, so I will just use simple 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, 1 2 3 4 5 6. Later on I will update. Okay, so I am not a robot. This one time zone we can set Indian time zone, and Indian time zone Asia Kolkata. Where it is, I'm going to check. This one. Okay, so I'm going to add this free account. Okay, they send the confirmation email. I'm going to confirm from my mobile. Okay, so I'm going to confirm my account here. Okay, I have confirmed my account now. Okay, from my mobile. Now I can go in members and I can do Amit PHP programmer here and log in to my account. Okay, so we able to log into our account, and now we can add the cron job here, cron jobs, and create cron job. And here we are going to specify cron job, but first the files we need to update, and I'm checking see all files are done. Now we will go inside vendors folder, and in composer this one, this folder also we are going to replace that complete folder, no issue. Okay, so I'm going to replace this complete folder this time, and now we are going to check. Okay, so let's see route file. One more file we need to update here, routes web.php. This one I think already done, we have already done this. Okay, no issue. So now we can check here. I'm going to check in my website where it is. Here it is. Okay, so I am going to add one product here, and then we'll see whether our PayU Money works online or not, whether the package has been installed or not. Okay, so let's see. So check out here. Okay, is going on. So PayU Money, now we can place order. Okay, few files still left. We need to update JS file as well. We have modified that function, that jQuery function for PayU Money. This is the file we need to update. Okay, now I'm going to refresh. PayU Money, now place order. Again, it is asking. Still, it has not updated. We need to check. Check validity to this. This file. content.js folder. Let's see. And this file we have already updated. We can check here which file it is. Please select payment method. We are going to search this one. Incomplete folder. See here, this is the file that we have already updated, main.js file in sample 6. Please select payment method, and that is fine. We have already updated this file, but I think main.js, why it is not updating? Sample 6 public JS frontend underscore JS. We can comment this function for the timing. I don't know why it is not picking. Okay, so we can comment here, and then I'm going to check. We can check online as well. Okay, that is fine. Now we are going to check here after refreshing. See, it might be picking from cookies. We can check in another browser as well, or need to delete the cookies as well. Okay, I'm going to check here in Chrome. Let's see here, the page is not coming fine. So I'm going to check in Chrome now. Amit2000@yahoo.com. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We are already having the product here. I'm going to check. Now we are going to check here. See, here it is working fine. See, IndiePay does not exist. So the issue is coming because this package has not been installed correctly online. Okay, so we can check it. So one more thing we can do here, we can go in our server, GoDaddy server. We can go, and in file manager we need to upload that vendor folder again, okay, because the package is not working. Here you can see IndiePay does not exist, error message is coming. So it means that some of the files are creating issue here. We will check once that in vendor folder, and also update this auto load. See, soft on package is here, but IndiePay, but some files, more files might need to update. I'm going to update these few files also. Composer we have already updated. I will upload once again. Okay, now I will update all these files from env. I will not update, but I'm going to update these files once again, and here I'm going will not update sample SQL as well, and all the other files we can update here. This STSS also we don't require to update, so but all other files we can update. Okay, so let's see. Okay, so now we are going to check here, still it is showing error. Some middleware file need to update, I don't know, but we will check some other. Oh, so it is giving us tough time. Another way is to modify all the project altogether. That will surely work, but it will take huge time. We will complete project, we might need to add again, so that is not easy task to do. we are looking for some solution. Okay, so we will do another way. I am going to take backup of .env file because that we require again, and one more file, database file as well. These two files we have updated online, so I am going to keep both these file. Okay, so .env file I am going to keep somewhere. In desktop I'm going to keep how to we can put somewhere here we can add no show. Okay, so .env and I'm going to put it here, htdocs no show, no env and database dot config email. Okay, this one also. Okay, so both these files we have kept here. Now we will upload complete project once again. So here we need to go in our GoDaddy once again. I will log into my account, sign in. Okay, so we don't have any other solution right now. I am going to my products here. I am going to web hosting and start Linux. This is our hosting, so I am going to here and then file manager. Okay, file manager, we can go straight away. And now I'm going to remove all the files and will upload again, and I'm going to in public HTML. And here what we can do, we can select all and remove everything. Okay, so few things, HTTPS also we require. We can open these files as well. Here I'm going to close all these files. This one all we have done offline. This is not required. Okay, and I'm going to open few files here. There must be two more files, .htss, it's in htdocs, sorry, it's in htdocs, yeah, it's in htdocs. is, I think these are the hidden property. Okay, so these are the files that we want to save, and I'm going to have these files edit. Okay, here in edit I'm going to have this one also edit. Okay, so now we are having these files. Now we can do other changes. Now we have HSS also that we require to update, and see all the files are there, this one also. Okay, so now I'm going to remove all complete files from this here, select all, and I'm going to delete everything. Okay, so this is the lengthy procedure, and I want to complete this series in 200 videos main thing. So I continue recording this video. I hope that you guys not get bored, because it is the process that I can't do straight away, because many errors come in this complete process. But we need to keep trying. We are developers, so such kind of problems do come, but we need to continue. And it is not that much easy, like you straight away can start something and can straight away complete that thing. It is not that thing. Okay, so it is development, so you will face such kind of issue, and I am facing right now. I am not prepared for such kind of things, like I am telling you right now. So such kind of things you will face at your end as well, and these things will help you that how I am sorting these issues at my end. Okay, so I'm going to upload everything once again. I'm going to upload my project. I'm going to delete earlier folders, or you can simply rename them. Okay, so I'm going to make compress sample 6 once again, and we'll upload this folder. I hope that it will not take much time uploading, and then I will unzip, and we'll see that no issue must come online. Okay, so now I'm going to upload this one. Upload, select files, XAMPP, htdocs, sample 6. There's a folder. Okay, make sure. Yeah, okay, so this has been done. I'm going to refresh, reload. Now I'm going to check here. Extracting these files. See, the file Zilla is taking too much time. Now from file manager we are uploading at fast pace. Okay, so now we can check that whether it will work fine or not. It can take few minutes, so you need to be patient. So like we have done that thing, one favor you can do for me, this one we can close, this one also we can close, hosting, this one, these links. Okay, this one also help us to do our job. Okay, so here if you will find this link in video description. Okay, so this one we have implemented for our API, that is working fine offline. Okay, we are updating online as well, but it is working fine. You have seen, you can upvote me if you are satisfied with this solution, that we are using this solution in our e-commerce website. Okay, so you can simply click here if you are having account in StackerFlow, and I want that every one of you must be having in StackerFlow account. Okay, so so that you can help me for that if you are satisfied with the answer. Okay, so now go back to that thing. It is taking time, we need to wait for a few more minutes. Okay, you can see the files have been uploaded. Okay, so we can close now. See here, sample 6 folder has been created. Now we can select all and move this one. I think manual level. Yeah, we need to move all files. Okay, so we can click select all and then move. And we can move all file to public and HTML like this. Okay, so go on. Now we can move back, and this sample 6 folder we can remove, that is not required now. Delete. Okay, now see, now this have been done. Now we can replace few of the files, like a few of the files we need to upload again as well. I'm going to refresh here. Okay, here you can see that many of the files have come back again. Okay, so like env file, we will replace here env, but we need to make sure that I'm going to check that whether we have done anything in our env file or not. This one I can close another folder. So here all these three files are here. Okay, so I'm going to check env here offline. We have done anything? I don't think we have done anything, but what we can do here, we can replace that env with our env. Okay, so we can do like this. I am going to edit that dot env file here. Edit, I will do like this. Okay, so I am going to check here another file. Is working. Yeah. And it is still working. How it is working? Can't connect to MySQL server through socket. Okay, yeah, see these issues have come up now, and we need to update config database.php. So we need to check composer. Still the package is not there. Why the package is still not there? Soft on EDP package is still not there. It is really strange. See, folder also not there. It is amazing. I'm going to check there in file manager. Vendor. Is not there, still not there. So it means there is some issue with the files. I'm going, I can go like this. I can put this one in one folder, sample underscore p, sample 6. Okay, so this is the folder vendor software, is there or not? Soften is there. Okay, so here Soften is not there. We will make sure it is there or not. Yeah, it's there. Soften is there. So Soften is there, you can see. Okay, so this one IndiePay as well. Okay, so in composer.json, this one we can edit here only. Here you can see Soften is also there. It is picking from cache, I think. Okay, so it is fine. Now we will refresh once again this one, and you can check that this might will work. Okay, so we'll go back now, check out. Okay, so now we will try once again. So that file still not working. So we can see here I'm going to check return. Check out pay money place order. See, still there is some issues. Soften, IndiePay, gateway, PayUmoney, gateway does not exist, target class does not exist. Still some issue is coming. Some issue is coming again, and this is some other issue now we are facing. Does target class PayUmoney gateway does not exist? So can update the gateway like this specify. We I don't know exactly this can resolve issue, but we can try once. It does not have, yeah, it is having IndiePay.php file, already having this file. Okay, so we can replace this one like this, and now we can check once again. See, now it is working fine. Oh, finally here the PayU gateway is working fine. Now only thing we need to do, from file manager we need to add that in operations we need to set the order ID. Okay, so it is bit complex. You might need to watch the video again. That so many things we have done to make it possible. PayU Money is now working off online. Okay, so now the another thing that we need to do, we need to go in phpMyAdmin and we need to set that order ID. Okay, because we are using the test account of PayU Money, so we need to have that unique order ID. Okay, so we will set it in the same way like what we have done offline. Okay, so we will set order ID here in orders operations. Okay, here I'm going to set something very complex. Okay, like 1 2 3 4 0 0 5 6 7, like this. Okay, so it will surely work now. Okay, so now I'm going to try once again, and now we'll go back to here. Okay, fine. Okay, now we'll place another PayU Money order, place order, and you can see the PayU Money is working fine online as well in our website. Okay, Stack Developers website is working. Oh, finally we able to do this one. Now we can set the API as well online, so you can check that our API link is, I'm going to open our API link, and that is PayU Money route. This one is our API link. Okay, so our API link here, it is Stack Developer XYZ, and this one. Okay, we can manually run this API as well. You can check it out, PayU Money/verify, Cron job run successfully. So API also working fine. So this is the link that we need to add in our Cron job. Okay, Cron job site that we have added, and here we need to add this link so that it will run in every 30 minutes. We will set it every 30 minutes it will run. So okay, so we can create this cron job here, and you can check it out that we able to create this cron job in this free website. Okay, so now it will run every half an hour, and it will update the status, like if we will make payment of this order like we have just placed. I'm going to make the payment with test card. Okay, so here I'm going to use that test card once again, like we have given there. Okay, PayU Money test card, and okay, so this is the test card that we are using there as well. Okay, so we got Amit 123, so it must be my 2020 pay now. Okay, so the payment has been made from our test card, you can see. Okay, so now see the status of this order must be payment captured. We are going to check in admin panel. Okay, so I'm going to update check the status in admin panel. Sorry, wrong URL. Admin 1 2 3 4 5 6, and you can check the status in admin panel here, view orders. So you can check here the payment capture status is coming fine. Okay, so now if in case I update the status to payment failed, I will update its status to payment failed. I'm going to update from our database that we have just opened some time back. Okay, from here see the last order status, I'm going to update this one to payment failed, though it is payment captured. In case the status not updated at client side, at admin side, payment failed. Okay, so now we are going to run the API. API will run automatically. Okay, here see, now the status is payment failed. Here you can check the status is payment failed. Yeah, okay, so here you can check the payment is status failed, payment failed. Okay, now this status will automatically update to payment captured after half an hour, because we have set the API there, we have set the cron job of that API. So this order status will automatically update to payment captured, and we can see this one. So in that cron job website, we can update that timing to something so that API can run faster, or we can manually run that API, because that API will run in half an hour, so we don't have that much time. So I'm going to manually run this one, because this API, that cron job will also run. You no need to do like this, like I have done, run this API manually, but you no need to do like this. Okay, I can remove all unwanted links here. Okay, so I manually run the API. So here I can close here, so you can check out payment failed. Now I'm going to refresh, and you can check out now the status is payment captured. So this URL now will run in cron job and will update the status automatically in half an hour. Okay, so that thing we have done now, and you can watch the video carefully. If some step are not clear, you can surely contact me in video description. So we have invested, we have spent more than 1 hour for this video for the first time. I want to complete the process. I want to make that pay you money online in our website, so that it will be clear that process we have done. We have uploaded that thing, you have seen that we need to upload the complete Laravel website again, because we have updated the package there, and that package we could not able to update through files. So we have done that, we have deleted the earlier folder from our server, and then again upload the website. So you might need to do the same thing at your end as well. Whenever you will upload your website, whenever you will add new package offline, then you might need to update the complete website once again. Okay, so here you have seen that we have set it as well. So anytime if the payment failed of any user, that order status will get update within half an hour. Order status will update from payment failed to payment captured. Okay, so in next video we will also work on PayPal IPN, PayPal transactional API. Okay, so that thing also we will do in next few videos to complete 200 videos of our e-com series. Okay, so that's all for now. Have a nice time. Goodbye.